Now we discuss some important questions for board examination. So question one is, the foci of a hyperbola coincides with the foci of ellipse x square upon 25 plus y square upon 9 is equal to 1. Find the equation of hyperbola if its eccentricity is 2. So given that equation of ellipse is x square upon 25 plus y square upon 9 is equal to 1 is equation of ellipse. Given that foci of hyperbola coincides with foci of ellipse, so first we find foci of ellipse. If we compare with x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1, then a square will be 25, b square will be 9. And eccentricity will be, we use for finding the eccentricity of hyperbola, we use given formula for find the eccentricity of ellipse, b square is equal to a square into 1 minus e square. B square is 9, a square is 25 into 1 minus e square, and 1 minus e square will be equal to 9 upon 25. It means e square will be equal to 1 minus 9 upon 25 is equal to 16 upon 25, and e will be equal to 4 upon 5. So 4 upon 5 is eccentricity of ellipse. So foci of ellipse will be plus minus a e 0, because foci of ellipse is plus minus a e 0. So a is 5 and e is 4 by 5, 0, and will be plus minus 4, 0 is foci of ellipse. But given that foci of ellipse coincide with foci of hyperbola, it means foci of hyperbola will be plus minus 4, 0. This is foci of hyperbola. So foci of hyperbola is plus minus 4, 0. Because foci of hyperbola coincide with foci of ellipse, but foci of hyperbola is plus minus AE 0. It means AE will be equal to 4. And given that eccentricity is 2, so now putting the value of E here, we find A will be equal to 4 by 2 or n is equal to 2. It means A is 2. So A is 2, now we find B. So B square is equal to A square into E square minus 1. So b square will be a square is 2. So a square will be 4 into e is given here 2. So 2 square is 4 minus 1. So b square will be equal to 12. So b square equal to 12 and a square will be equal to 4. It means equation of hyperbola is x square upon 4 minus y square upon 12 is equal to 1. This is required equation of hyperbola. Now we solve next problem. Find the equation of hyperbola whose conjugate axis is 5 and the distance between the foci is 13 is. Let the equation of hyperbola be x square upon a square minus y square upon b square is equal to 1. Given that length of conjugate axis is 5 and we know that length of conjugate axis is 2b, so 2b is equal to 5, it means b will be equal to 5 by 2. And given that distance between the foci is 13 and distance between the foci in case of hyperbola is 2ae, so 2ae is 13 here. So AE will be equal to 13 by 2. Now we find value of A, because in case of hyperbola, B square is equal to A square into E square minus 1. So B square will be equal to A square, E square minus A square. And A square will be equal to A square, E square minus B square. Now value of AE is 13 by 2. It means 169 by 4, and value of b is 5 by 2, it means 25 by 4. So a square will be equal to 144 divided by 4. So a will be equal to 6. So a is 6 and b is 5 by 2. So equation of hyperbola will be x square upon a square, and a is 6 here, so 36 minus y square upon b square, and b is given here 5 by 2, it means 25 by 4 is equal to 1. And x square upon 36 minus 4y square upon 25 is equal to 1, or 25x square minus 144y square is equal to 900 is required equation of hyperbola. Now we solve next problem. Find the length of the axis, the coordinates of the vertices and the foci, the eccentricity and length of the lattice rectum of the hyperbola 9x square minus 16y square is equal to 144. So given that equation of hyperbola is 9x square minus 16y square is equal to 144. So this equation can be written as x square upon 16 minus y square upon 9 is equal to 1. So if you compare given equation by x square upon a square minus y square upon b square is equal to 1, then we find a is equal to 4 and b is equal to 3 here. So using the formula for eccentricity, b square is equal to a square into e square minus 1, because b is 3, so 9 is equal to a is 4 here, so 16 into e square minus 1, or e square minus 1 will be equal to 9 upon 16, and e square will be equal to 1 plus 9 upon 16. So e square will be equal to 25 by 16, and e will be equal to 5 by 4. It means eccentricity of given hyperbola is 5 by 4 here. So we want to find here length of the axis. So there are two axes, transverse axis and conjugate axis. So length of transverse axis is equal to 2a, or will be equal to, because a is 4, so length of transverse axis will be 8. Now length of conjugate axis is equal to 2b, or is equal to 2 into b is given here 3, it means 6. Eccentricity e is equal to 5 by 4. Coordinates of vertices plus minus a0 is equal to plus minus 40. Coordinates of foci is plus minus a e 0 is equal to plus minus a is 4 here, and e is 5 by 4, it means plus minus 5 0. This is coordinates of foci. And length of lattice rectum is equal to 2b square upon a, and will be equal to 2 into b is 3 here, so 9, and a is 4, it means 9 by 2. This is length of lattice rectum. It means eccentricity is 5 by 4, length of lattice rectum is 9 by 2, length of transverse axis 8, length of conjugate axis 6, coordinates of vertices plus minus 40, and coordinates of foci is plus minus 50.